For its final offering for the 21st season, the Ateneo Blue Repertory presents the Tony Award-winning rock musical Spring Awakening. In 2007, it won 8 Tony Awards, including 1 for Best Musical.
Well, the musical centers on teenagers experiencing conflicting emotions, confusing thoughts, and the brave curiosity of adolescence in a riveting tale of woes told through rock music. Sounds familiar? Well, joining us on set, musical director Andre Pamintuan, and we're also joined by Nika Del Rosario, Lara Antonio, Maron Cruz, David Mercado, Gabby Perez, RJ Santillan, Boo Gabunada, Tin Amante, Franco Ramos, Aina Pacificador, and Aldrich Alcantara. Well, we've got a lot of guests this morning. Good morning to all of you
guys. The gang is all here. Good morning, everyone.
1, 2, 3.
Good morning.
Wonderful. Sounds
just
good.
Just like a real choir. Now, tell us a little bit more about the material. Like during our intro, we already said that it's a very well-known bit of material. I'm one of those people who is not so familiar with it. But just take us through the basics here, Boo.
Okay. Well, basically, Spring Awakening talks about the stories of adolescents going through different problems such as suicide. Mm-hmm. Going through problems with their relationships,
right?
Stuff like those.
You know, teenage stuff.
Yeah, teenage stuff.
But you know, it's sort of serious material. But it's sort of is it a lighthearted take? Is it a fairly angsty sort of piece?
Well, deeply, it is relevant to our society today with to the teenagers' problems. But the thing that is different about this is it's that it is set in a different time. Mm-hmm. Yet, even now, it's still relevant.
Okay.
Right. Well, I mean, we were talking about some of the issues that teenagers have to be faced with these days. Topics of sexuality. There's a little bit of confusion. I know one of the characters has these wild sexual dreams. Is that right?
That's appropriate for morning TV.
Which one is that? I know that's got to be comical and in the sense, you know, kind of just. Yeah, fun to play, told through rock music. How do you guys, make sure that you put your own kind of personal twist to the characters that you're playing?
Well, I guess all of us can relate to these characters very much.
Yeah.
So, although they're like different characters set in a different time, when we play these characters, we also give a part of ourselves in them.
What do you mean by set in a different time?
It's in Germany in the 1800s.
Okay, all right. Okay. We're all on the same page now.
We're all on the same page, right. Well, I mean, we could be centuries back, but I guess the problems
of adolescence. Things never
really
change. Yeah, things never really change.
We all go through those awkward moments. How are those issues brought about in the rock music? Does that give it a little bit more angst because you have that headbanger? Is it headbanger rock music? Or go ahead.
Actually, what happens in the musical is when the characters sing, they're expressing what's going on in their head.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all of their deepest thoughts or their innermost conflicts. They're brought out through the song of the musical.
Ah, I see. All right. So
songs in the musical. My bad.
The songs are actually talking about the thoughts. So you kind of get the thought bubbles of what's going on.
Well, speaking of the songs, what sort of music is in there? What numbers should people be looking forward to?
Well, it's written by Duncan Sheik, if you're familiar with him. He's a very famous songwriter. So the music is going to be alternative folk rock.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. With a bit of orchestration, like there's violins, there's a trumpet. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful music, actually.
Did you guys, are there aspects of it that were tweaked for the Filipino culture, since this is the Filipino staging, or is it pretty much the same as the one abroad?
Well, it's a college setting. The band is a bit smaller scale, although most of the basics are pretty much there. We still got the violin, we've still got the sax, still got everything we need.
So pretty much everything's in the story.
Sax and violence, you know, it's always a good combination as far as teenagers.
We have our own twist on it, our own blue rep style.
Right, which is what? How would you define the blue rep style?
Yes. Blue reps. Well.
Go on, pass the mic around. There you go.
We've been around for decades now, so I mean, we put a lot of youth and energy in it. Involve the audience with us, so that's really a lot of our style right there.
Okay, are you talking audience participation? Should we vocalize before we come to watch it?
I'm watching.
Make sure Ginger doesn't get a ticket. It could be ugly. It could get ugly. Yeah, is that what you're talking about? Yeah.
More like the audience feels like they're part of the musical,
okay,
but not necessarily the participant.
Hey, wouldn't necessarily want that. All right, well, so this is capping the season, I guess, for you guys, mm-hmm. and then a little bit of a break before you start the new season. Are there things that we can look forward to from Blue Rep? Throughout the year, 2013?
Yeah. Being very secretive. How very teenagerly of you.
Go write it in your diary. I'm just kidding. No?
Well, more awesome. We'll see. So they've got some big things planned, but we don't want to reveal.
I think always big things to expect from a group like this, really. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We're going to be flashing the details up on screen. I know you guys... Can we manage a little bit of a teaser from you guys? Maybe just a small taste of a performance? Just a little something, a cappella maybe? Sure. Give it a go, give it a try. Thanks for being a group of troopers. You guys are champions. We're flashing the details on screen right there. Spring Awakening, don't miss it. Here's a small excerpt from Spring Awakening.
I know it's so off. I love when you do stuff that's rude and so wrong. I go up to my room, turn the stereo on, shoot up some you in view of some song.